Mini chapter 14. Jaymi incarnates Amber. First doorway of no return. Jaymi shuts and locks the doors that lead outside to his middle story terrace, walks back across his study, and sits down again in front of the array of IT hardware spread across his desk. Returning his attention to the main monitor, he jumps in shock to see something he's certain he didn't put on screen before he got up from his chair. Amber's handsome and magnificently strong physiognomy in wide close-up, staring out through the glass and seeing straight into his maker. Hooking onto Jamie's desires, Amber addresses a specific suggestion at him with fluent articulacy, not in spoken words, but using that wide fluidity of intelligence and humour in his eyes. This suggestion, delivered with as charismatic a power as Jaymi has ever seen in anybody, is that Amber himself squeeze out into meat space through this monitor, then stand up in the flesh right here in Jamie's study, and then channel Jaymi in dealing with the dreary ones in whatever way Jaymi may wish to see them squirm. Does Jaymi doubt Amber would be effective in dealing with them in real life? Jaymi has to admit he does not doubt it. His admission is registered by the eyes on the screen. Well, they reply, then this result can be Jamie's. Think of the earthly power it would give him, if Jaymi will just be so kind as to let Amber squeeze loose into physical reality. Only Jaymi can make a beast clamber out into meat space like this. Only Jaymi when designing the beast who will clamber. No gamer in future, just Jaymi right now. So will he play, pretty please? Yes, he will, pretty thanks. Yes, he will play Amber's game, here and now, without a doubt. Jaymi can certainly picture what power he himself will gain by introducing Amber's strength and subversion into the lives of Bangdad's personnel. What a challenge, what sabotage, what loosening of deadweight by live voltage could thereby be achieved. And at this, he feels a forward surge of anger and ambition rising up, like a drumbeat of clattering momentum. Something has just changed within the last minute. For even if Jaymi were next to refuse Amber's offer, and he can still do this, he reminds himself, yet somehow his life from now on will not be able to stay as it has been. From here on, nothing will be able to quiet that drumbeat. So this was the oncoming thunderstorm he was sensing. He gets up, paces over to the locked door and looks out at the empty sunbeds on his terrace. One thing seems clear, just from looking at that face on screen. If Jaymi does consent to Amber's release, then this beast will indeed be effective in terrorising the dreary ones in their flesh and blood. Amber's suggestion, therefore, is a tempting offer. So tempting, in fact. Oh yes, indeed. Still, there does remain the option for him to turn back from this road. He doesn't have to accede in releasing his beast into meat space. If Jaymi refrains from releasing him, then Amber will not run wild, but will instead remain contained within the Platinum Raven. This is just the truth, and it's a simple one. Jamie's in control here. He's still the boss. He really is. But as he returns to the seat at the monitor, looking down at the floor while he sits, and then starts raising his gaze back towards Amber's face in close-up again, as he must, Jaymi already senses that in reality, despite the unknown dangers involved, he will be powerless against that offer being conveyed to him with such flickers of animal humour and intelligence in those wide-set eyes. And powerless he is. For as soon as he aims the glint in his own eyes back at the beast on screen, such an ecstatic charge of sweet dark vengeance spreads through him that he feels his bloodstream sing. So, here it comes at last then, the instant of dark pleasure, when one particular tap of Jamie's right index finger upon the Enter key on his keyboard, after the myriad similar sounding taps at the same key he has made over the months, just happens to be the tap that releases Amber out from the confines of his designs for the Platinum Raven and into life. Tap. There it was, a quiet convulsion. That one demure little key tap just pushed Jaymi across an invisible threshold from the ordinary world into another one that he's already sensing may be darker and brighter than he bargained for. And now it hits home with something like the queasy feeling in a swimmer when they are dragged sideways by an unexpected tide. This single keystroke has dropped him somewhere he cannot retreat from. There is no way but forwards into a flight he can't predict. Amber's eyes on screen close for the first time with a smile. A moment's stillness in the study. Then a low susurration and chatter speckles out behind Jaymi, as of archetypes peeping out from hiding places tucked behind the fabric of reality, ripping through that fabric and emerging through fissures in the air around the room, to reveal that every familiar 3D object is in reality just a curtain beyond which they've been hovering throughout his life, peering in at him. The whole study scene splits open as if it's a painting cut by a knife blade, while the air vibrates and hisses. And he catapults himself backwards into a corner, flesh tingling as he watches Amber slither and squeeze out into meat space through the monitor like a giant blonde serpent spider.